Shalom Aleichem, it's Yaakov Ram Shepard here from King David's Tomb, kingdavidthekabbalah.com, and I want to share with you another secret of the Jewish meditation, the Kabbalistic Jewish meditation, Darkei Shalom, that I'm basing on all of the Kabbalah books that I have here, Baruch Hashem. Basically, I'm taking a piece and I'm making an application for that, that it will be a practical meditation. So let's see. We have a very important book within the different books of the that is the sources of the Kabbalistic meditations. It is called שערי קדושה of the מהרח. We spoke about before in different classes, and I want to explain that that specific book of the שערי קדושה is divided to four parts. Okay, the first two parts is very very important, and this is preparation to have the spiritual elevation, okay? Meaning to follow the rules of the Torah and to get rid of the all kinds of negative attributes and so on, different habits and different things that are a stumbling block for us when we want to get to a real spiritual elevation, okay? Now, according to the שערי קדושה, that will be a prior condition before we are starting the real meditation. The real meditation starts in the third part, and specifically in the fourth part, that is the most deepest Kabbalistic meditations that Rabbi Chayyim Vital collected in the after all what he was learning through his life. So, the first two parts, like I said, are very important to learn, and Bezrat Hashem, we will go through them slowly, slowly. But for now, I want to take an example from the beginning of the third part, which is, it seems like a simple introduction of the concepts of the Kabbalah, and to show you how you can take every piece like that, every paragraph of any Kabbalah book, basically, if you really understand it, and make it to be a practical meditation for you to use, okay? So the piece goes that you, we have the Hashem, the ultimate Ein Sof, which is the source of everything. So he says, the Marchu, on that we don't have the permission to contemplate. I translate it to meditate, okay? So where are we starting our meditation, says the Marchu? From the extension of the light of the infinity that comes down to the five levels, which is the five worlds. What is the five worlds of the Kabbalah? The highest one is called Adam Kadmon. Then we have the Atzilut, Bria, Yetzira, Asiya. Okay, again, Adam Kadmon, Atzilut, Bria, Yetzira, Asiya. This is the five worlds that we're speaking about in the Kabbalah. Obviously, within each one of them, you have everything, and it gets multiplied, multiplied, multiplied many, many times, but let's leave it as simple as five worlds. Okay, now, within those five worlds, says the Marchu, and it's brought down in many other books of Kabbalah, you have the name Yudke Vavke. How so? The tip of the Yud, the Kotza Yud, is the, related with Adam Kadmon. Then the Yud itself is the Atzilut, first Hey is the Bria, the Vav is the Yetzirah, and the last Hey is the Asiya. Okay? I also brought it in the Kabbalistic Siddur that I made of Zichron David, Kabbalistic Meditations of the Arizal, so you can find it there in many, many introductions and practical meditations. Anyhow, you want to take this concept and to meditate with it, right? So how do you do that? Simple. You visualize in your mind the Yudke Vavke, and while you are going with your mind, with your meditation through the letters of Yudke Vavke, you imply the concept that you learn in this paragraph to the meditation, right? So you meditate on one letter and you put all of your understanding, for example, you say the Yud of the Yud Kevav, okay? And you put all of your understanding of what is the world of Atzilut in the meditation of the Yud of the Yud Kevav, okay? And so on, you continue to the Hey, and you put all your intention, all your meditation, all your strength with your understanding of what is the world of the Bria in the first Hey of the Yud Kevav, okay? Vav, all your, what you know about the Yetzirah, the last Hey, or what you know about the Asiya. And in this way, you took a piece of an introduction, right, of one of the books of the Kabbalah, and you make it to be an application for you to meditate on, right? Now, you can ask, okay, so like, what do I gain by that? So it is very, very important to know that when you do that, every time you do that, that will give you a tremendous strength to your neshama, okay? Because when you meditate on those concepts, so it brings your neshama to those levels, okay? Obviously, it's not that anyone, anytime can just think about Adam Kadmon and his neshama will be there, okay? But there is a part of us, of our neshama, that is within Adam Kadmon, it is part of that level, okay? We have part of different parts of our neshama in each one of the worlds. So when we are meditating on, for example, Adam Kadmon, we are awakening and we are connecting ourselves to this part of us, of our being, that is there in this world, okay? And this is very, very important understanding, very important secret, that it have many, many applications, many foundations of the Kabbalah is based on that. And that's also what I'm speaking about when in the book of Nefesh HaChaim, when I'm teaching it. So this is something that, again, if you apply that, it can change your life and bring you a tremendous, tremendous spiritual powers, abundance, happiness, joy, to be connected to Hashem through your day, through your life, Bezrat Hashem. So it is, if you want to be involved with those things, this is basically the way, and that's what I'm teaching here, and I hope that you will be enjoying those teachings and applying those meditations, practicing them, and bring this light into your soul, into your life, Bezrat Hashem. Baruch Adonai Le'olam. Amen v'amen.